Where's Theresa?
Listen, let me tell you something. I've never seen my wife act so crazy.
Really?
She is like so undecided what to wear.
I've never seen.
Yeah, she's not dressed. She's upstairs.
I'm gonna go up there and surprise her. Theresa?
Yes?
Hello?
Oh my God!
Where are you?
I'm not dressed. I'm not dressed.
Hi! Stop it! Look at you in your little tracksuit.
Hi.
Nice to meet you. How are you?
I'm good. I manhandled Larry a little bit.
Oh, good.
I couldn't help myself, but he's a good hugger.
He's a good hug, right?
Every good Long Island gal has, you know, an arsenal of clothing and shoes. I mean, come on, we're on Long Island. And I love checking out people's closets because I feel like that's where I do my best work. I'm just gonna go through here.
What are you going through my stuff for?
I don't know, it's just what I do when I'm here. And I do my best work in the closet, ironically.
Okay.
You are so organized.
I try.
I shouldn't even have my shoes on in here.
No, you can have your shoes on.
I was also looking for contraband, things that we might have wanted to throw out, but it was in pretty good shape. These are the best ever.
Well, should I wear them today? I didn't know what to do. I don't know if I should wear pants, if I should wear a dress.
Well, this would be really good with these shoes.
You think?
I mean, it's a little dressy, but why not?
Well, this is a very special occasion, and I should be dressed.
Right, yeah. If you're willing to break these in
I'll wear those.
That would be so fun. I'm gonna put these right here on your bench.
Okay.
I was like, I'm getting a reading from a well-dressed, over-the-top, fabulously accessorized medium. I'll be right downstairs with Larry.
Okay.
Okay.
Oh my God, this is tight. Uh-huh. Oh, this dress is a little hoochie mama.
Teresa,
what are you doing?
All right, I'm ready. I don't know about this.
I think it's gonna be good.
I'm only wearing this because you picked it up.
We'll let Larry decide.
I feel so silly.
You look great. What do you think, Larry?
I think she looks very hot.
Yeah, see? It worked. Okay, where do you want me?
You could sit here, that's perfect.
Okay. I'm a little nervous. I mean, it's kind of like a Ouija board, and it's kind of like the whole universe is opening up, and it's like, oh, what if I hear things I don't want to hear?
Okay. And I want to talk about the young energy that's departed. They told me they passed tragically.
Mm-hmm.
He talks about the rug. So do you have like a very expensive area rug in your apartment?
Huh.
What's with the rug?
Interesting.
Is there something about a rug?
I had a rug in my old apartment where he would visit often, and I just now found that rug again and put it in my new house in Pennsylvania. I just literally this weekend put it back out.
Okay. What it is to validate that his soul was with you at that moment.
Ah.
Crazy of a validation.
Right. My friend Al, out of all of my friends, he was the one who was the most full of life. He was an actor, he was a part-time drag queen, he was a kind, gentle, amazingly loving soul. He just got me.
So usually when they show me cirrhosis of the liver,
mm-hmm.
And then they make me feel like they never drank, it's
right.
My symbol for that they contracted it, the liver disease, in an unusual way. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
It wasn't from drinking, correct?
Right, it was not. It was hepatitis.
I didn't know they had it though. Undetected
for years,
and then it was too late.
Yes. Because he was exposed to hepatitis, and he had all this liver damage that he didn't know about, it was so far gone that it was pretty much inoperable. And we could hope for treatment, but treatment was usually not very successful. When you hear that, you know, your friend has a limited number of time, like 30 to 90 days to live, I think, you know, I love denial, so I was just like, no, that's not gonna happen. There would be times when he'd have to be rushed to the emergency room because he would start to get really, really ill. That's when you realize that probably it's not gonna end well, and we're not gonna have him as long as we thought.
So what he did was he was showing me everyone saying goodbye, but you missed the departure,
mm-hmm.
and you were not there for him to take his last breath because you were working. He said, that damn job.
Yes, that sounds like him.
To validate for you that he does not want you to feel that you were not there for him in his hour of need. He says, I don't want you to feel or carry any type of burden about not being there
mm-hmm.
the day that I died.
I was on a work trip and I got a call from one of my best friends saying, you know, we think it's gonna happen any time. We're all at the hospital. We're all gathered around his bed. We're telling him you know, are sending your love. And, you know, he passed when I wasn't there, which you always think, God, I should have been there. It's just, you know, you don't think that you ever do enough.
They just showed me horses that also departed as well.
Oh my God, I was just thinking that thought right now. And I was like, I hope she gets to this.
Do you still have that red braid?
Uh-huh, yeah, it's on my hat carrier that I take to every horse show. Interesting.
And so I am talking to a horse.
Yeah, that would be her, which is weird, but yes.
People have that question all the time.
Uh-huh.
Are animals able
right.
to communicate? And I say all the time, a soul is a soul, a bond
right.
is a bond.
Right.
It is energy, and there is a form of communication. But you had this one horse that was, I don't mean to sound quaint, but it felt like your best friend.
Soulmate, yeah.
I feel like she was a real show horse.
Yes.
She knew how to strut her stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And
totally.
You won a lot of things with her.
Because
mm-hmm. she keeps showing me the blue ribbons mm-hmm. and I see the pictures.
Yes. One of my biggest passions in life, besides dressing people and fashion, is actually horses. I was really fortunate enough to find this horse. Her name was Lola and she was a show girl. In 2009, at the World Championships, she was so good, and I was like, oh my gosh, I think we can win this. And we actually did.
And I kind of feel like things happen so quickly with her.
Very.
And I feel like you feel that you weren't there for her either.
I wasn't. It's another unsolved, mm-hmm. like, neurotic guilt thing that I have, so
okay.
yeah. I was showing her at the 2010 World Championships, and she was acting very weird. She took a funny step in the show ring and made like a noise like she was hurting, and I was like, something's wrong here. She got progressively sicker at the horse show, and they're like, we need to take her to the hospital. And I was like, absolutely, do whatever you need to do.
But there's something about her eyes.
Mm-hmm.
Her eyes, I cannot stop looking in her eyes, and I feel like she looks at me from this one side,
yes.
the one eye,
yes.
and she just stares at me and just looks like so deep into my soul.
Do you want to hear something really crazy?
Sure.
I was with her and they put her on a trailer and they had to rush her to the emergency room. And I saw her looking out the trailer window with just one eye, this mm-hmm. eye. And that was the last thing I saw of her. And she was like whinnying and like, I could see her eye, it was so intense and like scared.
And I feel that that was that she knew
mm-hmm.
that she was
wasn't
not gonna
back.
Make it.
Yeah.
So know that she says, it was time to let me go.
They get her to the hospital. They called and said, this horse has a tumor that's the size of a basketball and it weighed 38 pounds and she's out of surgery. And I'm still trying to get to the clinic. I turned off the highway to drive like a mile further and they called again and said, she was in recovery and had an aneurysm and collapsed and she's dead. That's the last image I have of her, is her in the trailer, like looking out the window with one eye. And that will always be a haunting image for me because that's the last time I saw her and I was like, hang on, I'll be there. And I wasn't.
So even the container that you have her cremains in,
mm-hmm.
I don't know if you wanted to change that.
Yeah.
She made me feel like, she goes, you know, I'm surprised Carson still has them in this box.
It's like a pink plastic pet casket. It's terrible. But I was gonna sprinkle some like at the horse show, I was gonna sprinkle some at the farm. I'm gonna put some on the mantle, so.
Perfect.
Sorry.
It's fine. She knows of all the plans and that you're willing
right.
to change it.
Okay, good. That's pretty amazing. Everything that she said during the reading, kind of all interconnected. Like, the people who you love are a matrix of people in your life, and it makes sense that they would be together in heaven.
I mean, it was such an honor to meet
you. Oh my gosh.
Now I feel like I have a new friend.
I know, we're gonna go riding.
Yes,
I'm
wanna
gonna
go
take
riding,
you.
Yes!
Call me when you need me to help pick out another outfit.
I will.
Give Larry a squeeze for me.
Oh, I sure will.
I really am a believer that our loved ones are with us all the time, but I think this just really validated that. Now, I'm a bigger believer, and it just makes you kind of breathe a sigh of relief that everybody's okay. I'll see you
Take
soon.
Care. Bye, Carson.
Okay, bye.